Hi, and welcome to another episode of Demystifying Medicine. On today's episode, we will cover cystic fibrosis. We will be discussing the basic biological principles of cystic fibrosis, the organs affected, and the various treatment options for this disease. So what do you, a panda, or a neighbor's pet have in common? You are all made up of cells. The cells can be thought of as the subunit of life. Inside these cells are a set of instructions called DNA. DNA is made up of the bases adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. You can think of these bases as instructions that code for genes in your body. For example, the DNA contains instructions for traits such as hair type, eye color, and height. When a nucleotide base is added, removed, or substituted, it is known as mutation. These mutations can change the DNA code, which may affect the traits that are expressed in your body. Now that we know the fundamental genetic makeup of our body, let's move to the next big question. What is cystic fibrosis? Cystic fibrosis is a disorder caused by mutation in the cystic fibrosis transmembrane conductance regulatory gene, known as CFTR for short. This mutation occurs on chromosome 7. This disease is an autosomal recessive disorder, which means that the disease is inherited when a child inherits a defective copy of the gene from both parents who are carriers of the gene. A carrier is an individual who has a defective copy and a normal copy of a gene, and is unaffected themselves. The CFTR gene codes for the CFTR protein, which is an important chloride channel. The purpose of this channel is to pump ions in and out of the cell. The symptoms and associated complications of cystic fibrosis are caused by the dysfunctional CFTR protein channel, which is found throughout the gastrointestinal tract. Affected individuals have elevated sweat electrolyte levels, pancreatic insufficiencies, and lung infections. These signs are observed in most patients, but not all, since severity of the disease can range widely amongst individuals. In Canada, 1 in 3,600 are born with this disease. Studies have shown that cystic fibrosis is more frequent in European Caucasian populations than in any other population around the world. In addition, in the mid-1900s, the median survival age of individuals with this disease was 8 years, but today, the median survival age has drastically improved to 30 years, mainly due to better understanding of the disease and improved clinical approaches. Now that we know more about the disease itself, let's talk about what organs are affected and the various treatment options available. Recent studies have shown a higher understanding of the underlying causes of cystic fibrosis at a genetic level. More than 1,500 genetic mutations have been linked to the onset of this disease. However, the most relevant mutation, found in 66% of affected patients, is the deletion of the phenylalanine in position 508 on the CFTR gene. This inherited disease mainly affects the lungs, pancreas, liver, intestine, and sinuses. The most prominent organ affected are the lungs. Excess mucus causes infections and eventual permanent lung damage due to trapped bacteria. Normal digestive functions are also altered by this disease, as the mucus blocks digestive enzymes from reaching the intestines. Therefore, food, specifically fats and proteins, are not digested properly in patients. Finally, inflammation and infection of the sinuses is a common effect of this disease, as this disease affects the layer of epithelium found in the upper respiratory tract. With this advanced knowledge of the causes of cystic fibrosis, a number of treatments have been proposed, with the intent of these treatments being to prevent and control infections in lungs by removing mucus and to prevent blockages in the intestines. A number of treatments for this disease are available, including antibiotics for infections of the airways, chest physical therapy, and other specific medications. Antibiotics are generally the primary treatment for people with cystic fibrosis, as they most likely will have a lung infection. Based on the type of bacteria and the severity of the patient's condition, there are different types of antibiotics that are available, some of which include oral, inhaled, or intravenous antibiotics. A second type of treatment is chest physical therapy, which serves as a way to loosen and remove mucus from the lungs. This should be done 3 to 4 times a day, and it involves repeatedly pounding one's chest and back in order to dislodge the mucus. As it might be physically demanding for some people, there are devices such as mechanical percussors or a positive expiratory pump mask, which both serve the purpose of clearing mucus from the airways. Cystic fibrosis can also be treated by medications, most notably a group called bronchodilators, which help to open the airways by relaxing the surrounding muscles. Finally, as mentioned before, the pancreas and intestines are unable to function efficiently because of this disease. Digestion of food becomes difficult, and eventually malnutrition becomes a cause of the disease. Prevention of malnutrition has become a greater focal point in recent years, as it could help the patient fight a persisting lung infection. Oral pancreatic enzymes are provided to help digest fats and proteins, and supplements of vitamin A, D, E, and K are provided to replenish the fat-soluble vitamins that the intestine can no longer absorb. By implementing these techniques, we can hope to continue lessening the incidence of this disease. That's all for today. Thanks for joining us on this episode of Demystifying Medicine. Thank you.